Welcome back to Jersey Matters. Here at the First Presbyterian Church of Trenton, I'm Dawn Stensland-Mendte, where a new sound finally rings after a 30-year silence.
This is the inauguration of the bell. This is the first time we've rung it in public and for people, so here goes. I have my little remote.
Jean Bickle is a believer on a mission to bring back a very special bell, and with it, hundreds of years of history.
I learned that there was a bell. We had a bell in the steeple, and not only was there a bell, that it was cast in 1807, which makes it one of the oldest bells probably in New Jersey, and one of the very oldest ones that was cast in the United States. The Liberty Bell, for example, was cast in England. So after the Revolution is when they started to have that kind of industry. So I was fascinated by the bell. I went up and looked at it, and then learned that the ringing mechanism had been broken for a long, long time.
Bickle educates visitors from across the region who come here to learn the history of a one-of-a-kind bell in New Jersey. Weighing 478 pounds, it was cast and hung by bell founder George Hederle.
I mean, this is a sound that from 1807 until maybe 20, 30 years ago was heard every day. Almost certainly it was rung, or at least every Sunday for services. So it's a historical part of our city. It was in the church, the Presbyterian Church was very prosperous. It was an important part of the town. And so this bell would have been familiar to everyone.
Bickle led fundraisers for years, and organizers say generous donations continue to come in to cover the $10,000 cost of restoring the historic bell.
We rededicate this tomb to the memory of Colonel Johann Gottlieb Rau. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, amen.
The church's burial grounds are full of history, too. Recently, these reenactors rededicated a new gravestone to Colonel Johann Rau, commander of the German troops stationed in Trenton and killed in the Battle of Trenton in December 1776. Historians say Presidents John Adams and James Monroe attended services at this church, as did the Marquis de Lafayette and Daniel Webster. This is the largest Greek Revival-style church in the state, and now home to a newly fixed, famous bronze bell that rings with history.
This nationally recognized historic church still serves this community, and when the bell rings at noon every day, the hungry and the homeless know they can come here for a hot meal. Just this month alone, serving 1,000 people, also providing coats for kids and adults, as well as baby supplies, diapers and bottles for babies and children. Reporting for Jersey Matters, Dawn Stensland-Mendte in Trenton. Up next, Larry's commentary.